This Uncle Sam poster is the most famous of all American posters. We have taken Uncle Sam off the board, and it has been cleaned. And the best known version of Uncle Sam. Time for Uncle Sam to be linen-backed. We've done 5 of these posters. This is the 5th one we've done in the past 10 years. There are other posters that have Uncle Sam's image on them, done by Flagg during the World War I period, such as this one, and this one, and there may be others I'm not aware of. This poster is his most famous work, made in 1917 to encourage recruitment in the United States Army during World War I. Over 4 million copies of this poster were printed during World War I, and it was revived for World War II, reprinted. Flagg used his own face for that of Uncle Sam. At his peak, James Montgomery Flagg was reported to have been the highest paid magazine illustrator in America. In 1946, Flagg published his autobiography, Roses and Buckshot. Apart from his work as an illustrator, Flagg painted portraits, which reveal the influence of John Singer Sargent. I love Sargent. Great artist. Great American artist. Flagg's sitters included Mark Twain, Ethel Barrymore, his portrait of Jack Dempsey. This poster is faded. We were going to bleach it, but after it came off the old canvas, I decided to just wash it.
and it did brighten up.
Thank you. We're going to put this Booth line poster right next to Uncle Sam. For Brian.
I paint all your, I don't have to match it.
Yeah, if you paint all of it, you don't have to match. I think the Titan buff color is good for that.
So, isn't it too dark?
Let's see.
Put a little bit white.
Let's see, it doesn't. Try it again. No, I think it's great. I think it's perfect. You don't have to mix it with white, just paint everything.
Sorry.
That looks good. Color is good. I think.
What?
I think it's good. Without mixing. You agree or not?
I don't know.
It's important that we use reversible water-based colors when we work on a vintage poster like this. When we mix the color, it's important that we match the shine of the poster so that the touch-up looks the same and doesn't shine in a different way. Yeah, we gotta brighten up the red. Don't mess with his face too much.
Bow tie.
The bow tie should match the letter. and the borderline. It's basically the right color. Also, the red around the letters should be all brighter.
Is it pinker than this?
Not that.
Huh?
No, not that. Not
is
that.
Is it pinkier?
Yeah, pinkier, but lighter,
this.
A little bit lighter than that. Actually, maybe you can go by this as your standard. Base it on that. This is more faded than that, I think. Anyway, when you get it mixed, call me and I'll come over and tell you if you like it or not.
There.
On the poster?
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, I think that's good.
A little yellow.
You could put a little yellow in it, you mean?
I put a little yellow. Is it okay?
Yeah, you could lighten it a tiny bit. You can lighten it a tiny bit because it's going to darken when it dries anyway.
Theoretically, all this work is reversible with water. However, you wouldn't want to really try to reverse it while it's fresh and new. It's more reversible once it gets old and dried out, 30 or 40 years in the future.
Is the color okay?
Yeah, the color is great.
Write down something here.
Yeah. We're gonna put in that information here. Thank you.
I want you for U.S. Army. And then get a job at the post office and you can do nothing. Collect money.
Now we're going to finish the touch-up.
We have to do this.
Hey, Pete. Please.